boulder right there. There we go. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Look at that. Oh boy. Look at that split shot rig. The do nothing, simplest thing in the world, man. A little fat worm. Look at that. Tell you what I'm gonna do, man. Put them poles down. Right there. Look at that. And a fat fish to start my day, right there. On the little fat finesse worm and split shot rig. Look at that. Wow, I feel confident. First thing in the morning, I'm just gonna grab them like that, right there. Look at that. Wow. What do you think, huh? Nice little start. You find that? I'm gonna show you exactly what I'm doing here, man. Hold on, fish. Just pop that hook out. Just like that. That's it right there. Simple little thing. Catching smallmouth bass in June in Ontario. Let's let them go. Ready? Go on, fish. We're looking for giants. Let me show you exactly what we're doing this week on the Extreme Bass Angler. The simplest setup almost known to mankind. And what is that? Just a little split shot. I've got a number one, two, and three options, depending on the size of the finesse worm I'm going to use, rigged up, right, threaded up through the line tie, come down the middle part of the bait, and pushed up, and then just slowly over the hook eye. It's a little split shot, finesse, bass. I've got the little owner, wide gap, three-odd hook, and a little thick-bodied finesse worm. And I put it through the flat side, right through the nose. Okay, find a little point. Come down about half inch, quarter inch, right through the center. Push it up over the line tie, onto the line a bit. Make sure it's flat like that. Then take it, come down into the worm body, put it through, find the center. Make sure that's nice and straight, otherwise your line will get all kinked up. Look how it sits. I can run my finger there. It's nice and flat. When a fish bites, you know what happens. You just crunch, punch, and catch. Let's go. Now I'm making that cast. I'm watching it. It sinks. Let it go down. Engage the reel. And just lift. And just envision you're mixing up that sand and gravel or making noise with that split shot, stirring up the sand. And that little worm is behind, is wavering behind. Killer combination, boy. It's a real simple setup. It's like fishing them with a shaky head or something else. That little worm, I said it before, I'll say it again, it's so unintimidating, but it's a killer presentation and setup in pressured lakes, real clear water. And anytime you want to have some fun, catch them with the spinning rod. Anything you see in the water, man, throw to. Oh, there we go. See that? Ho, ho, ho. A little tree in the water. And what's there? Smallmouth bass. Come on, boy. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Can't beat the finesse worm, man. Look at that. Nice fish. That water is still, it's a late spring here in Ontario. And it's still a little cold, so they're not psychotic. But they sure want to eat, don't they? They sure want to eat. Come here, boy. I got that net ready in case I get myself a 5 or 6 pounder. But these 3 pounders, look at that. Nice chunky fish, huh? Beautiful bass. There you go, another nice little fish. Go on, get. Split shot rig, man, you cannot beat it. When you're working on shorelines and stuff and looking for those fish that want a toned down meal, but just will still eat. You just gotta be versatile. Sometimes change it up to a smaller bait and you're gonna catch them. Let's rig it back up and catch some more. And it's real simple. I just cast out that little worm, let it settle to the bottom and just lift and drag. Real simple, man. I mean, you talk about a simple way, especially on pressured lakes. Tournaments, if you're a co-angler and stuff, you throw a little wacky rig or you throw a little, you know, wacky setup, or the little shaky head. Same idea. Smaller bait, little profile, and especially for pressured fish. Whack! You know, when fish are aggressive, hey, you can use anything to catch them. or when the conditions apply with lots of wind, you know, different things and things oriented. But when they're a little spooky in shallow water, these fish are now post-spawn here. So they're just roaming around, sitting on boulders and stuff. That's just their natural habitat. They need to go near cover. But this little bait dragged, and the premise is the little split shot. I've got it about, 16 inches above the hook. So it just drags in the sand, makes a little noise on the rocks. And what do they see dragging behind? That little finesse worm. I mean, deadly.